Yes, we are live now. Yes. Hello, my dudes. Hello. We are back with the robot game. And what the fuck has happened to my microphone? Why is it over there? Hold on. There we go. That should be better. Okay. Hello, everyone. I am the Kong Lord. Once again here, bringing you some MechWarrior action with my man Texan here. We have the Aces Wild against TM. MP or whatever, Timp or Simp or Timp. Whatever. Anyway, I don't even know what like the letters present. What does it mean, dude? Doesn't mean anything. So let's just go. They're gonna drop into the 1v1 right now, and we're going too fast. I guess so. Let's just.
They're ready to go. Might as well.
Yeah. I have to ask what that means.
I have no idea what this week's mechs are, though.
I know that they're gonna play Marauders now, though. I've seen this before. It was an exhibition match that took like 10 years because they're standard engine Marauders. You can actually run out of time if they don't find each other in time.
And on the Timp... Oh, it's toddlers in the mosh pit. That's what it means, apparently.
Look at my man Bob's mech. Look at that swag. It has all the searchlights and decals and are there. Chainsaw. Another chainsaw. And this one is straight from the factory. Straight from the factory, my man. Okay, both are in Med 2C8s. Our guy gave the permission that if you don't own this mech, you could play the normal Med 2C, but with a specific build.
For the matchup.
But the problem with that is that. Has worse agility, so both have opted in for the better one. And shots have been fired. Let's go.
Some equal traits from both sides.
Oh yeah. Did you say this already? But toddlers in a mosh pit. Let's go.
Yeah.
My man just noticed it. Let's go. I have to update that in the actual team sheet. I'm just gonna tab out now. Nothing's really happening. I'll leave.
Some equal damage on both sides. Both have you like oranges. Oh, and here comes a strike on Myriad.
Oh, not just Bob, not Bob. Look at that. It's like directly standing on a strike. And bam, 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 bam. 3%. Yikes. PGI, please.
RNG.
He was directly standing on it. But if that was an airstrike, that could have done some more. But Myriad is losing in percentage. But let's see the. Or actually, wait a minute. I'm already looking at it. His paper also. Let's see. Bob's stuff. Well, Bob's not too bad. Left arm, slight damage. Everything else is pretty much fine. I think he got this.
Took a little bit of internals. Maybe he got heatsink or two grit.
Ouch, ouch. I think Bob is.
On his right torso is almost open. Red armor over there. About the peak with it as well.
Nice hit the first one, second volley didn't hit from Bob. Didn't get hit either. Those both missed again while he hit.
Timp is in a really bad situation here with the trades. Maybe he should try alphaing three of them.
Bob's leg just got opened. It's not broken. Oh no, there goes the bolt on. No. Hey, Bob's gonna push in.
He's gonna straight up.
It's
push
time.
Push up.
Yeah, it's time to get that guy. Too much hiding. But I mean, yeah, it doesn't matter if he pushes or not.
Oh, and Myriad is now open CT.
Yeah, I think it's actually.
Like 2 points of armor on that torso.
Bob's right torso, but that. only has like one PPC, I think, on these builds. That doesn't matter if the
he lost a PP. Myriad has lost a PPC.
Oof. Also, these are standard engines, so if you lose a side, it doesn't affect your heat too much. You only lose heat sinks. Oh, almost took not Bob's right torso. Almost took the right torso there. Let's see, Myriad's. Oh, Myriad's like open everywhere.
And doesn't... here comes Bob with his.
Oh, no! Okay, there we go. Oh, we looked in the right direction. Bob lost something. Yeah, he lost the torso. Not a big deal, to be honest, since he's pretty fresh everywhere else. I think Myriad is in deep trouble here. Oh, missed! Probably, like, the mech dropped a little bit and he missed because of that. That's annoying when that happens.
But, Bob takes it with both wings on his back.
There we go. Not too many Boltons lost. Lost a couple searchlights and the other chain, so... Looks pretty healthy otherwise. Why is my game lagging like this? What's up? Well, whatever, at least it loads.
NA servers?
I mean, like, everything takes a year to load.
That too.
Anyway... Punching the stats... That was... Ace Wild victory and toddlers in a mosh pit loss. That's what it means, folks.
Yes, in peace, toddlers.
quick look at the scoreboard.
Okay.
Nothing to see here, really. It's 2-1. I think.
Is mining the first map?
I already forgot. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, it is.
Nice, nice. Right, let's go mining. Game mode already in conquest, my man. Let's go. And then now we do the waiting game where we wait for our guys. Our dudes.
Yeah, let's take a look at the possible map. Mining collect plays and throws. It's a medium to light mech drop. 4 lights. 1 medium. Majority of people would probably go brawl.
Medium pulse go wub wub in this map.
Yes.
Definitely will go wub wub.
Just hopefully one team doesn't forget their JJs with their wub wubs.
Yeah.
Otherwise, a perfect corral of getting surrounded by the high ground buildings. And usually before, ends in those teams' demise.
Can't wait that someone actually brings a piranha here. So far, all the piranhas I've seen haven't done much. And I think this definitely isn't the map to bring a piranha in. When it's the light medium drop, you're kind of screwed if you take a bad position. Even in a good position, you can be screwed on this map if you have to run away.
Yeah, but that mistlings field could be potentially
easier
to flank in. Even though it's quite slow.
I wonder how much MC that... all the Boltons on the Marauder on Notbob cost. That was like 4, 5, 6, 5 Boltons, I think. Wings count as 1. So, yikes, like 2k MC. Why do I even care, really?
Alright, when their fifth player arrives, I'm gonna start the 5-minute count.
My man, okay, wait a minute, they switched teams, I have to do it in my sheet, I have to do it in
AW wanted,
there we go. Also, shoutouts to my man, Firehawk in the chat, we go way back. And, Shoutouts to my guy IL Orso. 10v1 flags. Let's go. What's happening? Un momento, por favor.
Maybe someone got a really bad stomach bug? Question mark from chat?
My man.
From what I'm hearing.
They need one guy, and also we should... Actually, nah. Fuck the rules, dude. Let's not enforce the time. We're all chill here. Right?
Yeah.
And then, like, 2 minutes later, probably I'm super frustrated and then it's time to go. Full on, what should I say, Stalin mode. When is his poo-poo time over?
That's a little bit blunt. It was all right.
Come on, let's go, dudes. Let's go. So, the mystery guy.
Do we want to take a look at the maps chat instead of the all chat talking about shit?
I mean, dude. I'm not sure if there's anything to discuss in this. Let me switch it. I mean, we can doodle something here. Like, there's nothing to discuss really about the light drop. Shit happens.
Can we get Under the Trace anime on it, Kappa?
But anyway, yeah, there's a...
Under Wolf in your chat, we need your help.
Not much can happen here, you just take some good spots somewhere. Blah, blah, blah. You've seen this before. Good spots, and probably clump up and ask about it. Whatever, dude. Whatever. My enthusiasm for casting totally isn't gone, guys. I still care. I care more than ever.
Absolutely. It's the most important thing left in the game. This cast.
Are we allowed to draw funny stuff on the map on stream?
I don't see why they ban us. Right?
I don't know. Well, I mean, I could try. Hold on. I think everyone knows that this spot is a pretty good place. So I think they could spawn one guy in Bravo and send a guy like this over there. Like that. Into that spot, and same thing could be for the Alpha Lands. That's a pretty good spot right there. There we go. And what else?
I mean, there might be a really wide flank from Alpha Lands possible.
From where? the fucking guy is still not here. Okay. Never mind. I was just about to tell them that time's up. 5 minutes. But okay, there he is. So we can get back to watching the chat instead of like killing time in the most stupid way possible. And Black Temp Rap, no, not from me at least. I think Ash will stream some random game after this. Okay, hey.
Yeah. Hopefully, yeah, look. It ends up going fast.
Okay, they said we good. Okay. Let's ask them what's up. Remember to set one team today and the other tonight. My man. They are green, but saying nothing. Locked, good luck. Okay, let's go.
Alright, let's start.
Let's go watch them robots die, dudes. Division E action. The best of the best have gathered here. On this day, the mining collective, they will fight over for pointless reasons we don't have to know. Well, let's see how they're gonna do it.
I will take blue team sign.
My man.
Just waiting for everyone to load in. Any day now.
Oh, there's that fucking dude that keeps crying about my camera control. He said facepalm. We didn't even get to start yet. Already facepalming. So, wait a minute. Oh no! Nice.
Oh, okay.
Oof.
Didn't want to wait a couple more years.
There we go. Okay, my man. You got the blue team, my dude. And I can already say, wow.
Alright, so we have an 6 MPL crab. MPL wolfhound with 6. Very hot. We have a shard with HMGs and 2 heavy smalls.
Well, since... Oh, okay. Psychomatic crashed because he's spinning here. 5-medium pulse, by the way.
I think this is gonna have to end up in a redraw.
I don't know. Oh, wait, yeah, definitely. This guy's moving. This guy's still moving. Like,
oh, how dare you?
Oh.
The crasher.
Now look at the commando's arm. I didn't even know you can get the bolt on it. I need this drill, dude. Anyway, since they're like crashing around, we could go through over the mechs. Still, you already set the blue side. I'll go through the reds. Reds, Mr. Commando with smalls and SRMs. People could look at it just now. K9, medium pulse, simple stuff. Javelin, 6 SRM, 2 DPS, god.
What? If he doesn't return really soon, we're just gonna have to redraw.
Yeah, but the packet 6 SRM, 6 Artemis. Oh man, and the DC will come, but. Oh no. Did you look at this Incubus build?
I did not say it.
Did you not say it because you dare not to say it, or.
I just didn't say it because we were interrupted by someone holding again.
Oh, I don't really. Yeah. They're probably not gonna change their mechs. I believe Noah's gonna ghost. It's too late already because we got a good look at the mech, so why not just, like, go with it? And they're not gonna redrop, I think.
They wanna play it like this.
It's up to them if they wanna play or redrop. What the hell is Incubus? What the hell? They didn't say anything. Okay, they're moving.
Alright.
They're like, what assholes? They never said yes. They just go move. And now they can't. This is fuck. This is a mess, dude. Yeah. This is a mess.
JB action. Don't forget that. It's a 4 HTML incubus, by like, the way.
Not sure if they did that on purpose. Probably not, but I think that can be seen as a pretty asshole move. But anyway, should probably inform them after this that they should actually say something before they start moving. But let's see if it actually makes a difference before we start complaining. Psychomatic is totally clueless about the enemies on his left. Okay, you noticed, got a little bit of scratch damage there.
As well, I think our... preparing to push around the corner?
Hey, if they don't shoot the shot, I think that's gonna do some damage. 6 heavy machine guns, big DPS.
Yeah, that strike completely missed.
Well. Herbie has a super good spot, but where is he
going?
What
is Herbie doing? He's NASCARing around.
Vroom, 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 vroom. Oh, the Huntsman's gonna die. Huntsman, you are
Huntsman's like... right on top of the strike.
Yeah, oh.
There we go.
The incubus strikes. The shard strikes, but the wolfhound got what he deserved, I guess.
Oh, and that javelin's almost lagged as well.
How do I turn off this name label? So, actually, that's pretty disturbing. Okay, anyway. Yeah, incubus could... Oh! That guy got, like, shot once, lagged, and... shot twice, dead.
AW has the two-person advantage now.
The shards, shooting beyond
shooting
optimal.
Machine guns, yeah.
Beyond
I think
optimal.
That was beyond max range.
Yep.
At that point.
Heavy machine guns are like, isn't it like 90 meters or something like that? Oh,
yeah. Oh.
There he goes. Okay, it didn't matter really.
Skyfire is now on the low ground with Zerby.
It didn't matter that they start like moving on their own. Without saying anything, I guess. There we go. Fast. Very fast. As soon as that action happened. I don't know what's up with Derby. He's like farming on this top spot. And
he's shooting. That looks like a really slow wolfhound, right?
Probably looks like standard engine or light engine. Probably light. It's not that slow. It's probably like 108. 108 at least.
Oh, I mean, yeah, it's like 108, but stand 30.
Yeah, but anyway, the Herbie, like, he was farming back shots, but let's go run
and
around.
He ran onto the low ground.
I mean, did you see, like, the direction where he ran? Like, counterclockwise NASCAR around the barrel. My man, the inner pug got to him. What a shame.
The sensation was too great.
It is a racing game after all, I guess.
Yes.
You look at all the Twitch streams, they all had the racing game tag for some reason.
It's the default state of MechWarrior Online, dude.
Okay, dude, the commando lost the drill, sadly.
Yeah.
Press F in the chat. Hours. There goes the bolt on.
And our next map will be River City.
I'm tired of showing the actual readouts, so I'll just look into them myself, and if there's any team damage, then I'll only show them. Actually, wait a minute, I have to show them, because otherwise I can't see them, so let's... Okay, dude, so let's see the player stats.
Big brain time.
Well, yeah, Ace is Wild, classic, they always do some team damage, and this time, once again, 14, 18, 16. Noticeable numbers. Probably airstrikes. Anyway, quick run to the stats. 4-1... Blah, blah, blah. Let's see what's up, my dudes. Why is it a black screen?
It just works.
I mean, my TOC scoreboard, black screen. I don't think this is supposed to
A feature? Question mark?
Okay, whatever, it's not working. Let's just go. Oh, wait a minute. No. Didn't do that shit. let's delete the markings because we're gonna have an actual map now. Also, why is my this thing flashing? What's up? Sky Phoenix friend request always my man. I will accept from my guys. The overlay is incorrect. What do you mean, dude? Get out of here. This is fine. Oh, it probably didn't show it because I didn't press enter. Oh, fuck. Fuck me. Fuck me in the ass, bros. I mean, not literally, but you know what I mean, dude.
100%.
Yeah, there's your daily dose of cringe once again.
It's purely platonic.
Okay, so let's see. River City. Let's continue with this.
Alright.
With this, I don't know what to call this. A circus, maybe?
Yeah.
I mean, the state of the stream is a circus because I can't get the... I can't get the scenes to work. But anyway, let's see if this works. There we go. We can see the River City. River City. And actually, here we can see some real strats. I'm pretty sure we could be able to see some strats. Theta is the conquest point they will fight over. And if I go by experience, you might not actually see a brawl here, but it's TVE. Anything can happen. You might even see Lerms. It's pretty unpredictable. So actually, I should not theorycraft too much about the actual strats that can be run, but instead probably the spots they want. Well, top of the Citadel is a good one. Spaceport is a pretty good one. Lurking around here, pretty much on the edge of the spaceport, is a good one for the blues, and for the reds, Upper City, classic, and the garden is pretty classic. It's also pretty easy to advance from there. And I think the distances are too high for this mech, so we might not see the bridge in this one. I hope they do not go water. Water is not life in this map. Unless the enemies are not watching from the Citadel, then they could do the classic pug push. I'll call it that. And seems like the... What was this team called? And toddlers in a mosh pit, they lost a player.
Yeah. Again. Yeah, we're still giving them 5 minutes.
No, poo-poo time, please. This match would be better without Q merger. What does this mean?
Big brain time. Ooh, I think they're about to get ready, but Bravo Charlie, so looks like AW is just going to go straight through the city. Doesn't want to deal with any of that airport nonsense from their own team side.
Wait a minute, the spawns, let me switch back to the map strats. So the spawns, team 1, Bravo Charlie, they are already locked. Bravo Charlie, team 1, blue side. That means these two over here. And let's see what the other team's gonna do. They are not locked, but I think they adjusted to Alpha Bravo. And again, they lost a player.
Goddamn.
Come on, dudes. But Alpha Bravo is... makes sense. Usually people don't want to spawn Charlie. It kind of gives away the Upper City approach. So I will expect they will stick with these.
Tim, please, just get ready. We need more of that high octane rotation. Preferably from a Nerby. Kappa.
Rust body pillow, my man. Oh, they are just at the Bravo lens. But where's the dude? Come on. It's time to enter the game and play some Bing Bing Wahoo Robots. Come on. There we go.
Ah, there we go.
My man, Commodore Corned Beef. My man. That's my boy, by the way. Shoutouts to him. My man. We don't go too much way back, but we go back a little, let's say that. Like,
right,
a week or two.
Oh wait, I forgot. Time of day. Day.
almost screwed them up. One of them spawns with night, one of them spawns with day.
But you see, man, just make the time of day completely random and everyone will have a different time of day.
My man.
From what I heard.
There we go. River City, home. At least it was before the remake. My game runs like shit on this map.
Time and day is a perfectly good feature, Cap.
Oops. I should have probably muted, but I don't think it's even the time of day that's like ruining it. It just lags for me all the time, like low FPS.
Yeah.
You'll see, dude. You'll see.
You see, that was actually just a lag spike.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I first of all didn't even cross my mind to mute, and second of all, even if it crossed my mind, I will not know what I bound the button to. Okay, there we go. The bands have already started. And let's see the FPS. Yes, like, I'm dipping into reds at some, like, hovering around 20 to 30 FPS.
Guess Magic. I'll check airport side. Can you check left?
Which one is left? It's the direction right. Where you NASCAR to. Never mind, that's right. Okay. Okay, so...
Okay. SRM Bushwhacker with a Brawl Onion, a Brawl Vapor Eagle, and the last two mechs. Wow, that's a weird Assassin 23 with 3 SRM-4s with Artemis and medium lasers, and just a SRM-36 with Artemis packet.
Okay. Was that it all? Was it all?
Yeah.
Okay, we have some what the fuck on the other side. Lerm Novacat, my man! What was the Vulcan? Medium pulse, and this Cicada is the best. My man. I think it needed a bigger gun, but I think this will do. LB-20 for medium laser Cicada. Shot fired already, and the Bushwhacker was boring UACs, Vapor Eagle boring UACs. I mean, not UACs, sorry, ATMs. But yeah, the missiles are going whoosh in this one.
Yeah, praise crystals.
My man. I can't say that too much because it's becoming too popular meme right now.
Yeah.
We have to figure out something else, like... I don't know.
A boomer said it
once. Unga boonga me shoot missile. I think that could be the new slogan. Okay, so blues were like complete raw, I suppose. Unless he was.
Here comes blue left. Teams.
Yeah. They're chasing the Vulcan, but Vulcan's not giving a crap.
Oh, and that onion! Almost dead!
Not the missiles! Whoosh! Whoosh!
Ah, and they're now stalling.
He survived. Oh, no. The Vapor shot the wrong target. They were behind the rock. He should have just insta-kill the assassin.
The Big Eagle gave his entire back to the enemy and didn't get punished
But, I mean, aces are getting wrecked right now. But they're getting into that minimum range. Okay, the assassin is dead. I think that
Big Eagle's almost down.
Nova Cat should cross into the water, in my opinion, and make the missiles go whoosh from there.
Wow, he's focusing on the almost dead mech.
There we go, there we go. Oh, and they lost the Vapor Eagle, that's actually big. Okay, Nova Cats, you're already dead, dude.
Yeah.
But okay, they get some back shots thanks to that. The Nova Cats, pretty big mech. Okay, actually, I was gonna say that it might survive. Didn't survive at all. But the Cicada, my man. The Cicada. It's too confusing for the enemies. I think that's the, like, main reason why they're getting wrecked. Totally not the missiles. Yeah, it's the Cicada, guys.
But I don't think they're gonna get this final kill.
Yeah, it's no chance unless headshot.
This headshot with was Esteron.
Yeah, my man. But yeah, my man with the Cicada, this guy is the king of this game. Look at him. I don't care how much damage he did, but this guy is the king. First of all, Cicada. Second of all, mean build. Let's go, my dude. Big points to that guy. And also the fellow Lermer. Don't really care about the ATMs. No shoutouts for him, except that I think I just did because I mentioned him, but whatever. My man Lermer, my man Meme Cicada. Let's go.
Skill you get, yeah. Nope.
They deserve that win because of that Cicada. Like, if someone says Lermer's got cancer, this Cicada forgives every sin their team did. Based chat. Apparently I'm gonna get banned now for a jump scare. Get out of here, dude. Get out of here. I believe if this was like a paid position to shoutcast matches, I don't think I would be here. Like, I will not have even properly passed the tests, but who cares? This is reality. We are doing this for free. I have no idea why I'm even, like, doing this right now. It's almost 4 a.m. for me. Like, what the fuck am I doing with my life? I could be sleeping, but instead just like watching this Bing Bing Wahoo Robots, yay one up video games. But anyway, that was the sad story of aces getting learned, I think. Yes, kinda. Yeah. Almost 400 damage, let's say it was that. They didn't expect the Lerms, like, probably no one does. You can expect the ATMs, but not the Lerms. Never the Lerms. And, okay, nothing interesting going in the team damages. It's nice to see that team took a game.
The next map is Bog.
Bog 2. Okay, let's see if the sheet now works. Let's go. Please. Yes. Yes.
Oh, there's a day for Bog as well?
Yeah. Yep. If it's like nighttime, you see nothing. And the game is pretty much even. 1 point lead for Aces Wild. Nice. That's really nice to see. Bog, heavies and the assault. A man in the bog. Welcome to the jungle. Let's have some theme music for this if I find something. Let's see. Let's go with this playlist here. I'll just keep this playing for the wall of Boardman. We're going to the jungle. And let's see the map strats. I hope it's not too loud. What can I... Okay, there we go. That's fine. That's good. Perfect. But anyway, Virdianbo Conquest. Let's see the map strat. What does it say?
Stuff. It's a bit.
Let's see what it says.
So remember, we're going down to the low ground of Data Unbog.
Oh, is it that again? Probably
it
is.
Yeah, it's.
I mean, it could be Theta, right? Actually, yeah, Theta's the only, in quotes, balanced. But I don't think it's a fun spot to play in. Well, anyway...
You don't like being down and dirty with the freaking sewage water?
No, I am the big brain who actually farms the guys that do the dumb thing and go down there.
Yes. Understandable.
Just gonna say that marking this with a... some random mech for the mad dog up there. A spot is king. Let's actually mark all the king spots with the mad dog. King... King, and let's mark the not-so-king, but still okay spots. These are my opinions though, they do not reflect reality, these are just my opinions. But I think lurking from there could work. Possibly as sights, but there's the carapace in the front, fuck that shit dude. We've seen some dudes in these spots. I think that's a spot you can climb into, maybe. Could even have a scout there. Bam, bam,
okay,
whatever.
So both teams are ready.
Nice, nice. But anyway, like the map strat is basically just put a mech on every single hill or what do you call those? I don't know.
Mini mountains? Question mark?
Yeah, whatever. Call them what you want, but anyway, the game's starting.
They could look like green tumors from an aerial point of view.
Oh, look, Starwolf, Ladywolf in the chat. Low French.
Yeah, Solaris won, guys.
I mean, I don't miss Solaris at all now that we have the group queues back. I love it, dude. Like, actually can play the game without, like, getting tilted. Not that, like, not saying that, like, I'm stomping every game with friends. I'm just saying that it's fun to play with friends. Even if you lose, it's fun to look at the reasons why we lost, like, the dudes running... stupid shit like light PPC, rocket launcher, assassin, and stuff like that. But anyway, I'm on the blue side, by the way. Just spawned here.
Yeah, I went to the red side.
Okay, so
as soon as it starts, I will say red team. Alright, normal UAC 30 Mad Cat, MRM IV4 with two ear smalls, standard Brawl Onion. UAC 30 night with a madcap build essentially and a twin PPC sum.
Okay dude, I'll just have to play this one sound file I have saved. What is this? Hold on, get rid of the music, where is it?
You need me to cover blue team as well?
Not yet. Okay, there it is, so...
I mean, there are...
Pause the music, but, like, what the hell is that build? Like... Like, what the hell is this, guys?
It may be amazing. Why is that?
Look at
what
the...
What's that? What the fuck is that?
Like, what the...
Dude, that king crab.
Like, oh my god. Okay, that, yeah. I just stared at it all this time. It had the Lurmer, some brawl shit, but what the fuck that king crab. Anyway, let's see what's up. They're fighting. King Crab's getting shot and returned fire to Orion.
King Crab traded well against the Onion.
Quick draw. Merms going whoosh. Mad Cat farming a little bit. Hey, who's that guy? Nightshear with some. I think that's AC juice.
The Nightshear's having so many missiles come in from two angles.
Whoosh! Whoosh! Let's go see what's up.
I think
side.
He's going down to the low ground.
Yeah, that's not good.
40%.
Yep, that's not good at all. But there's also super smoke on Ace's matchup.
Oh, Ace's Wild is overcommitting, I think.
But they're kind of pincering them right now. But they're so hurt. When
they're so fucked.
If they would have had like better health, this would work pretty well.
Tip is rotating onto the low ground to kill that one onion. You think this will be their demise?
Maybe that Nova Cat's alive still. Never mind, dude. Let that obliterate. Yeah, actually, yeah. Even their like health were low.
Oh, and the Nightshear in the back is getting flanked by the wide flank quick draw.
Yeah, no chance for him.
Slow to deal with it.
But just saying, like, I thought this could have ended bad, but they all at the same time it was a like a pincering move, so. They
went onto the low ground, just overcommit to that onion.
And there goes the. Nothing yet. What am I talking about?
That I-4 is almost dead.
Roughneck annihilated. Okay, King Crab's gonna fire at will. Did he shoot the rockets already? Probably he did, because he didn't shoot at that guy. He's dead now. Wait a minute, what the fuck? The quick draw lost to the Nightshear. Oh no,
one of the weirdest
comebacks. Gross. I think the quick draw got too cocky. Way too cocky.
Yeah. In Orphaning your summoner still completely freaking fresh.
Nice, good job, Aces. Let's go. It looked grim. At some points, especially when the Nightshear got lurmed, but like that was the most weird outcome this match could have had.
Yeah, that Nova Cat just might have been positioned way too far after that Nightshear just got clacked to cripple status. Still has both of his legs though, I think. No, okay, just one. All of his guns, though. That's weird.
Okay, my friends in the chat saying usual Myriad build, I suppose. I didn't know, but God have mercy on his soul if this is like normal for him. That build is normal.
Okay, we saw some pretty normal builds last match. It's just that King Crab, what the heck is that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the Cicada wasn't, to be honest, it wasn't a normal build, but that was funny. Anyway. Rip, no support for the cheer. Oh, my man. Oh, yeah, they have to delay.
Yeah, he just got left behind and somehow 1v1 an IV4. Some freaking
hell. Bad kid! Mad Cat! Farm! Okay, enough with the music. We're out of Vietnam now. Enough with the music. So let's get a lot of the stats. Okay, no team damage. That's boring. 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 And that was a one kill loss for our guys.
Alright, next map will also Frozen City.
Let's see what the scoreboard says now. Probably not much. Should be like 25 to something, 26 to something. Let's see, 24 maybe. I don't know, I'm bad at math. I also forgot what the starting point was. Why is this animation so laggy? Get out of here. 24 to 15. Not too bad. Two more drops left. Anything can happen. It's pretty much basically even. Unless Aces take the next one, then it's not even.
And then they just need to make a comeback and it'll be perfectly even. As all things should be, Cap.
I mean, Tim should win now, and then we can call this an even set. You could say the Aces had an ace up in their sleeve. Aha, didn't steal that joke from that guy who said it in the chat. My man. Okay, that's enough of that second daily dose of cringe. Frozen City, yikes. 4 assault, 1 light drop. Potential to be interesting. Potential to be a blue laser slingfest. But I wanna see some weird stuff. Just saying. So, the map strat, instead of drawing anything that makes sense, I just saying that I want to see this push happen from the blues, or this push from the reds, or even this push from this big NASCAR. Actually, not that far. You like. Actually, if they send a light from them, that could be viable since it's fast enough. But then you got cap, so it should do like big NASCAR. Now that's a NASCAR lap. Almost half a lap. Could still do like this, and then you could call it a lap. Whatever. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on in before. Okay, I actually did have to stretch it up. Almost embarrassed myself there. I'm sorry that I didn't watch the Quick Draw versus Nightshear. I just presumed that the wrecked Nightshear would die, but seems like I should have been there to see what happened, because seems like there was an upset.
Obviously, you needed a higher point of view. Just be 50 miles up above the map, that you can see everything. Big green strip.
Yeah. Big upset back there. The Nightshear killing the Quick Draw. The Hunter became the Hunted, so to say. And
it seems like a lot of these Quick Draws are getting hunted by what they're supposed to count.
Fuck this microphone. I think I accidentally did something to it and it's like out of position again. Whatever. There we go. And people leaving the lobby.
Yikes. I mean, they only have 5 minutes.
Probably building mechs, I guess. Actually, let's put that music back on. Never mind. Sorry, I closed the tab already. Check to make sure in settings you have browser hardware acceleration enabled. We'll do that right now, actually. Where actually, too confusing. Options too confusing. What is this quote interesting? I already forgot what I said.
Just watch everyone go Executioner, Gargoyle, and other Brawl Assaults, 5-head.
Kong's enforced builds. People probably don't know the meme, but yes, there was a time when I bullied Starwolf by forcing him to play questionable builds. But some of them actually turned out to be working, like the Kitchen Sink Direwolf. That one with a shitload of everything.
I think SPNC is about to be ready so we can launch.
SPNC, dude! Yikes!
They have a couple of...
Scuffed streamer. Scuffed, no, not streamer. I'm the streamer. Scuffed shoutcaster. Let's go. Professional. In quotes. Yikes.
Next.
Okay.
Alright, from the lances we saw...
Toddlers in a mosh pit.
Team 2, they're just going to try to go the freaking 7 line, 6 line, I'm assuming, with those positions. They don't want to trade at all at the extreme range.
I'm glad someone paid attention to their lenses. I was like, I just like reading the chat and like...
Chat is best.
Why do I even read it, dude, though? Because you're all mean there.
Yeah, toxic.
Toxic spectators. But I mean...
I bet they even say GG after games.
Yeah, but to be honest, dude, like, I think games' only purpose is that, like, people can be toxic to other people without consequences. So it's okay. Fine. Bullying is fine. I endorse bullying, but anyway, what the fuck that dude in the King Crab again? Let me go through this first because I think they have some memes here. Once again, Myriad, oh my god, come on, dude. Okay, my man, Sky Phoenix, Heavy Goose, Annie. There's a Kit Fox, not at all Kit Fox this time, it's a Streak SRM6, we've seen that from them before. Dart Vapor. Wait a minute, what is he doing here? Is he in two teams?
I don't know.
Isn't this supposed to be an SPNC? What is he doing here? Well, whatever.
Yeah, I told you there was two SPNC guys.
What the fuck is that? Actually, not too bad, actually, that Blood Asper is fine in my book. Kinda.
Warhawk. Oh, and what the heck? That Warhawk A with quad peeps? What are you doing, sir?
Wrong variant, doesn't matter much, he's gonna farm, say it so.
Alright, but they have a standard quad peeps Warhawk set of 8, an 8 ACG Dire.
Ultraviolet, my man. Matt
a 5 UX, 5 Annie, and a Goss peep Madcat 2B.
Yeah. I should probably run my Goose Madcat on the B.
Still, though.
Dark shaders. But look at that!
Wow, doesn't seem to know that they're just... Toddlers in the mosh pit.
No, not the hecking King Crabberino. Not the hecking good boy. There he goes. In the front lines. It's time to fire.
Oh, he needs to have flag.
Wait a minute. Okay, this on. They still got two flags left. I think he did have a third at some point. Oh, no, he didn't. He has the exhaust pipes instead. Yeah, here we go. He's leading the NASCAR into the enemies, but the Annie has a pretty damn good build against the push. 5
yeah.
USC 5s. Dire's also so not too bad if they don't shoot it fast enough.
I don't know why the Warhawk's pushing up so forward, though.
He's being cheeky. Okay, the Annie's gonna open fire. Ooh. Heavy Goose hit on the Annie. Oh, 66! Oh! I think he shot the rockets. He shot the rockets, yeah. Rockets into the torso. And just the rockets and what the hell? The commando! There's a commando behind the King Crab now. Let's go! The baby! And... Pimper Warhawk is in... it's in Zimbabwe, literally.
It's humping him. But he's about to
he's stuck! He got hit by streaks. Another one's incoming, like, 2 seconds. One. Fired wheel. Shit, he lost the lock. Come on, fire, please shoot the streaks. Oh no, not the hacking King Crabberino, the good boy. Yeah. My boop is not King Crabberino.
Just getting pushed on.
Oof, well, he didn't really have a build for that distance. Triple USE 5 2-yard large. He got outgunned pretty damn hard, and Kit Fox never actually shot the commando after that first time. Might be a yikes in my book.
But he just doesn't have...
Yeah, the commando got cocky now since he knows that the Kid Fox stands no chance. Oh, the Annie's gone. Annie's gone, sadly. This looks like a firewall, dude. Like, the Warhawk isn't gonna kill anyone. Pretty sure if looking
just
at the
kill heads. Them all, Warhawk. We yeah. believe in you.
It's time to 5v1. Shoot the heads. Time to shoot the heads. Let's go. Click the head. Okay, close, but they took some damage there. Let's see his health. Oh, yeah. Ouch. I think Bob
is
alpha.
Here comes the commando, the humping death.
Okay, the commando's probably gonna kill steal this one. I want to see Bob alpha strike. Do it!
Hey, it's not a kill
steal. Do it!
It's a kill
unlimited
steal.
Power. Oh, pussy. Oh. Pussy. He didn't even alpha strike. But whatever. No matter. Good job. 5-0. Let's go. And there goes Tim's chances for taking the set, because Aces will be leading with like 20 points now, and after this one, it's gonna be the last drop. You cannot grouse more than 10 points in one match. So not looking too good for Timps. Toddlers in the mosh pit.
Toddlers did pretty well closing the distance, it's just that they
Well, I mean... They only had the King Crab and Annie as actual, like, decks that can do, like, that close-range fighting. The Blood Ash was pure yikes for close-range fighting. You can see that on the damages. Meanwhile, they had the Ultraviolet farm Annie. Well, it got, like, health by the King Crab. Explains the damages, but that's also pretty good stopping power. Goose PPC, big alpha striking. Warhawk also not too bad if you get pushed, as long as you get like a windows where you can cool down instead of getting farmed while you're at 90. And the commando did a good job distracting and being an asshole, so to say the least.
Alright, and the last match for this set will be on Canyon Network Theta with the most balanced drop.
We go way back. Gonna just quickly look at the stats. Nothing to see here, really. A punch in the scores. That was a pretty clean 5-0. Shame to TIMP, since I would have liked to see like a so-called match point match, but that's not gonna happen now anymore. But once again, just saying that losing a set doesn't mean you lose the tournament. Points, what you gather overall, will matter the most, but I think Aces are doing pretty damn good in their division. Don't remember how it looks like. I could actually go check right now. I think Aces are going really strong in their division right now. Let's see if this thing will load. Let's see what's up. Division E. Yes. Yep, Aces leading by almost 40 points compared to SPNC. Oof. I think this one's in their bag, dude. They got this. Let me congratulate them in advance. Grats, Aces, for taking the victory. Yes, yeah, they're already about 40 points ahead, and this looks like they're gonna get something like probably from 34 to 44 points. And SPNC cannot really catch up, since they're already like 40 behind. So already grats in advance. People are discussing if the Kid Fox jammed. when it was trying to launch the streaks. I'm pretty sure it didn't jam. That commando build doesn't run ECM, I'm pretty sure. Just that the commando was like doing laps around the Kid Fox, and you know when they did the change that you have to pretty much have the cursor on the enemy in order to get a lock. Probably broke the lock too many times and never got to shoot. Don't be harsh on the Blood Asp. I don't think he was suited for that encounter there with triple USC5 and we are largest. But anyway, he did make a conscious choice to actually run that build though. So I get okay. Yeah. You can blame him. Guess. 5 minutes for team. Let's go. Let's make this a good one. Still wondering about what are the SPNC dudes doing this team. Probably gonna.
Do you think they renamed?
Nope. They are a different team. SPNC is number 2 in the tournament scores, while Timp is the 4th. They are definitely different teams.
Okay.
Might be that they have possibly run out of players and probably got some special permission to send in some reinforcements. And that is fine to keep the show rolling, in my opinion.
I think SPNC, I mean Timp. Timp, SPNC. Yeah. You can't people to play some.
Well, it's starting to like slowly turn into SPNC at this point. Like they started with 0 SPNCs, now then they had 1, now they have 2. Soon they will be the majority. And what can we call it? I don't know. SPNC Timp Dominion, I guess. Yes.
Okay, so they're ready.
Nice. Well, not enough time to draw anything on the map. I don't think anyone cares anyway. I don't.
Just waiting for that Div E action. Can we get some laps? I haven't seen laps on Canyon.
I just like saying, dude, like it's pointless to like draw strats on the map in this division because the meta is like a whole another world to what we know. Anything can happen. I think those matches you just saw are pretty much like. prime example that anything can happen. Right. Like that king crab. I didn't even know that it could cross someone's mind to do a build like that on the king crab. Please don't do it again. Because like,
oh, they want you to rate their builds.
Huh? I was loading.
So oh.
I never saw what they typed. I can't even type because they're. Holy Jesus.
Have you tried pressing P and then alt chat?
Holy Jesus. We have.
What is it?
The Marauder has like a shitload of levels. Look at that shit. Look at that dude. I think that's learn 20. And one streak for his 4 tags.
Oh, the Raven
4 3-0. Tags. 4 tags. And he shot once and overheated instantly from the ghost hit. Is this the Dadless? Yes, it is. Look at the Dadless. Take a look at the Dadless. And the Bushwhacker's also a dad build. Jaeger mech, is that a dad build? They're already fine. Yes, it is a dad build. And what was the Raven? What does the Raven have? I have to see this.
Build to Chili Chad from AW.
Okay, so the Raven's also a dad build. Let's go. So who's gonna win? It's gonna be a tough one. It's the real mechs versus the dads. Mech dads. No offense to the mech dads, but you know, everyone, that's like the official term we use about builds like this.
I think the... Oh no, the Raven's caught out! They realize he's there!
Oh no!
He's still far away,
not,
you.
Not the hacking Raverino!
Oh. Not the boopy snoot! No! You killed my boy!
But I think it's payback time. The lerms are flying and quad tag is doing work. Quad tag and... holy Jesus, like... I don't know what to say. People are
Christ,
probably...
How slow is that? Is that 32 kph, my man?
Oh yeah, it is. Look, I think it's full throttle. Now that's a... super heavy mech, let's call it that.
Oh yeah.
The Omegas has been added to the game. That's an Omega. At least.
Guys, can you please hold locks for
hey,
my
hey, the Cicada, Cicada, the LBX Cicada makes a comeback. So, equally meme mechs on the enemy team, confirmed. The match of our lifetime, let's go. Lerm 5's flinging from the Atlas, some 10s and a 20 is also going in. But my man in the Marauder, like, let's go my dude.
Oh, and the Atlas is exposing! Will his Mac Dad list will survive?
Ah, didn't take too much. Is that the blood ass with the Yarn Larges
again?
Oh, just
the Cicada's game flagged.
Oh, it's 5 UC5, it's a farm build, let's go. A man with the farm build. It's not sure if it's healthy to comment in the middle of the match, but I just had to throw that in. I might make him happy. Might actually throw him off though, because it's like spectator interference, like, I don't know, he's like reading the chat now and he's can't learn while reading, I guess, or something like that. But what is this game? Like, why hasn't like anyone died after the Draven? But he died too fast. Oh. The Marauder got some streaks.
They're scared at the bracket builds. They can't engage.
Is that a Lerm 10 or Lerm 5 on the Jaeger? Lerm 10. And a Rack 2. And a Flamer. It's a dragon. I mean, not the mech, but like a dragon. Breach fire. Look. Whoosh. Well, to be honest, yeah, I think the reason why they're running these builds is because they know that they won their division already. So why not just have some fun? Like, if you know, like...
if that, anyone dies from this deck, that's bonus points, right?
Yeah.
Kefa.
Third-person drone. Oh no, Texan! Texan!
Oh, fuck.
Oh no no no, I think it's time to redrop all matches, am I right? Oh my god, this fucking lobby runner, dude.
Get out of here, dude. You're fired. But I mean, to be honest, this probably is the last stream we can do anyway, since it's week 6. But yeah, you're fired. Safe to say.
Damn.
The Dadless is doing the dad push. The dad push is going, oh, he is stripped.
Yeah.
Rack 2s and 5s are still there. Oh, too spooky for you. Raids on his back. Goodbye, dude. Not looking good for
SCR. I mean, all of them are using third person on AWS side.
Yep, my
truly
man.
The most immersive way to play.
Not sure if this is VMing to the blues though. I hope they don't mind. Because
well,
like
here comes the Jaeger.
This
it's
is like
flamer.
This is like
he about to win.
This is pretty much shit talking right now. Because you're all chatting this shit. I hope blues
oh,
don't
no.
mind.
Matthew's game flank.
He got NASCAR. Look, he got Pog NASCAR. Look where they're coming from. That's Pog NASCAR.
He was too slow to get out of from there, and Pog NASCAR got to him.
Okay, Bob. No chance. See you later, dude. Wait a minute. They're farming him. They're farming him.
Oh no.
The farm.
Wait, he might have had so much back armor.
Yeah. Well. Yeah, actually, look, he got hit in the back and it's like orange. What the hell? Holy Jesus. And I want to see the stats.
Raven, 0, 0.
I think that's like, is that the first, like, legit 0 we can, like, we've seen in a while?
He had dual narcs and tag.
Didn't he have a streak? He had a streak, I'm pretty sure, but I'm just saying this here one last time.
0, 0 damage, Raven, 0.
Since this is probably the last, a stream for this tournament, might as well break people's ears while at it. Let's see if they did some team damage though, because if they did, then hats off to you dudes. How do you team damage with Lerms, which have minimum range? Let's see.
Hey, but they had flamers, dude. They might have accidentally flamed them.
Okay, 3 team damage from the Bushwhacker, but it did have some other weapons than Lerms. But anyway, that was not surprising that they didn't kill anyone with that deck. So let's see the end.
Just underestimate its power.
Let's see. Thirty-five to 26, the final score. But yeah, this was like a... You actually took a time machine to the 2018 comp. Or actually you didn't, because those were not stock mechs. They were worse, in fact. Worse than stock mechs. But... I think...
Do you want to do interviews?
Maybe, I guess, since, like, I think they deserve it for bringing that deck, I guess. I'm gonna summon them. They want to. Not gonna stop them. Just gonna, okay, there's Bob, gonna drag him in now. Hello, dude, hello.
Hello!
Just gonna say this isn't gonna be an interview because I don't know what to ask, like, after that.
fair enough. did you like our build on that last drop?
maybe, maybe.
I think we made all the mech dads proud.
Or you did the reverse, that you mocked them.
Or did the reverse.
Yeah. Yeah, you inspired Kong to take his next Daedalus into comp.
Perfect. Perfect.
Yeah, that Daedalus, though, my man. And also I like the 4-tag Marauder.
The 4-tag Marauder.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, if you like get critted and you lose
a
tag.
Well, yeah, because if you lose one arm, you have another tag for backup.
Yeah, and also it looks scary also, when you have four beams.
It's terrifying. Yeah,
it looks scary. It's like lumbering towards you, 32 kph, and...
And they have no idea what's going to happen. Yeah. And then they're blinded by the light, and it's glorious. And then Schwartz and our Bushwhacker had every single machine gun.
My man. Yeah, some extra crit-seeking if you actually get close.
Oh, absolutely. So you have one for long-range touching, one for mid-range touching, and one for short-range touching. You have all your bases covered.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. But Let's talk more about the Marauder. I noticed that it shut down immediately at the start when it tested its weapons.
It did, yeah. We were double-checking our heat cap on there. Turns out he doesn't have a heat cap.
Do you have a standard 200 on that Marauder, by the way?
You know, I have to ask him what exactly he has on there, but it's pretty slow. It's probably it probably is a standard 200, honestly.
Yeah, it was
any speeds, my man.
Yeah, quick mass, learn 20, I think it was. Is that like the maximum you can actually get in this game? I don't know.
I think you can go a little bit more.
Maybe. If you
take in the S.
Yeah, should have stripped all the armor off. So you can.
Oh, we should have.
Yeah, but he might have run out of crit slots. Oh, there's Sky Phoenix gonna drag him in, and let's see what he has to say. There we go. Hello, my dude.
What's up?
Hello.
What's up?
What's cracking, man?
What's happening?
Okay, so first off, how do you feel? Did you enjoy that even though, you kind of lost the set, but
yeah,
it was fun to watch, dude.
It was very fun to play. I don't know. I've been trying to hold a Divi team together this whole season with five players at most. So every day it's funny. Like one guy was like, "Oh, I didn't know it was a whole match you guys wanted me to play. I gotta go."
Oh no.
Scheduling.
Holy based. Holy
yeah, we need more people. We have maybe 6 people in my unit, so whatever.
Okay, right on.
Also, dude, I noticed that your team slowly started turning into SPNC. If you follow the stream, Texan actually started calling you SPNC by accident.
Oh, great. Yeah, that happened when we were supposed to fight them, and 3 of my pilots flaked out. So they let us borrow 2 of their pilots, and we just kind of kept them.
Fair enough.
What a gross. Now.
Thanks.
They had awesome. 37 or something on the roster.
Oh, yeah. I remember when people were talking about that when the tournament started. That was funny.
Are you telling me it's not more than 50? I thought they had more.
Well, I remember...
For the 5v5.
I remember, I think it was 2 comp seasons ago, we put our whole Aces Wild roster on one of our MRBC teams. It was 180 people on there for one roster. It was great.
I mean, why not have a Aces Wild division at that point?
We practically did.
Same thing for SPNC. You should have done that on there. But yeah, Sky, you cannot really talk for them since you are not the SPNC leader, though. So why are we talking about them? So, okay, first of all, my opinions about your games. Big bonus to the Cicada. Let's go. Let's go, my dude. LB10 yeah. Cicada. That's fun to see. And also, I think I lost a few brain cells when I saw the King Crab build.
Oh, yeah. That thing with a bunch of rockets. In a 1v1, it usually just takes anything out. But after that initial punch, it needs some help.
Good thing we're playing comp. That is not 1v1.
You're right. Maybe. I think 5v5 is if you take out one assault quick, you have a big advantage.
Wait, but what happened to that 1v1 between the Night Quick Draw? What was the comms for those 2 people?
Oh, yeah, we didn't see that. We just presumed that Quick Draw's gonna win. Didn't watch. Oops, Nightjar wins.
So, actually, the Nightjar just won, because we actually got a couple of shots early on that IV4 before he went and pressured our Nightjar. So we had, I think it was open CT before he even walked in there. Our Nightjar was legged, but he still had all of his CT armor, so he was just fine and had all of his weapons. So I think he was able to just tap through the CT twice and kill him.
Okay, so he was fake hurt. He was actually fresh.
Yeah, basically. His leg was damaged, his leg was blown off, but he was just fine otherwise.
He's just fine.
It's just a flesh wound.
Someone's mentioning me. Oh. Game IDs. Ugh. I think I might, if I can dig them from the system, let me see.
I did click them, but I didn't record them after that.
I put all the, how do I even get these now? I did put them in
the stats up.
I did put them in the stats.
Oh yeah, in that.
Yeah, that whatever.
URL, yeah.
Whatever this
is. Yeah, they're talking about Bobby stat thing.
I guess it would be good to know what the score was.
So let me just actually, what does this do? Okay, I think this will do. I think I could just click, and also why am I even like saying all these things to you guys? Like,
because you can.
Now we know that you're clicking.
Yeah. I have to let them know what I'm doing.
Oh yeah, otherwise it's just like, oh my god, I hear noises, I'm scared.
And the rated other channel. Congrats, good job, Lex.
Huh? Oh my god.
My rated other channel in the middle.
Are you serious? Yeah, no, Crash used rated MVO2.
RIP. GG.
Oh no.
Oh, that was still a meme last drop.
Oh, that's exactly what